Amen.
Can we read Isaiah 55?
Isaiah 45.
Isaiah 55. It's found in the Old Testament. We start from verse 8.
The term of verse 8.
For my thoughts are not your thoughts.
Amen.
Nor are your ways my ways, declares the Lord.
Amen.
For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts.
Amen.
For as the rain and snow come down from heaven and do not return there without watering the earth, making it bear and sprout and providing seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so will my word be which goes out of my mouth. So will my word be which goes out of my mouth.
Amen.
It will not return to me void. Void means useless. Or without results. Without accomplishing what I desire.
Amen.
Can you see that?
Amen.
Let's pray.
Arrapele.
You can read until 12. God, Father, thank you for your word. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I just want to read the last two verses there.
11
and 12.
11
it says, so will my word be which goes out of my mouth, and it will not return to me void, without accomplishing what I desire, and without succeeding in the matter for which I send it. For you will go out from exile with joy.
Amen.
And be led forth by the Lord himself with peace. Then the mountains and the hills will break forth into shouts of joy before you, and all the trees of the field will clap their hands. Can you see that verse we have read there?
Amen.
Yes, I want us to talk about God's process. God's process. Especially when I read here, I just find how God works. There's something that you need to know, that if we talk about God's process, we are talking about God's way of doing things. I found that we normally develop formulas of taking us somewhere. But many times, or many times, you find that we don't understand His ways. And if you can read there, He's the one who's declaring it to us today. And He said, as heavens is so higher than the earth, so are my thoughts and my ways. In other words, when God wants to do things, it takes only His calculations and answers from Him. And if you want to find those answers, you need to ask Him. It goes by God Himself without anybody. It's Him alone who does it. And Him alone who knows why He's doing that. If you read, going down, especially verse 10, it says, for as the rain and snow come down from heaven, and not return there without watering the earth, making it bear and sprout, and provide seed to the sower, it says, so will my word be which goes out of my mouth. He was talking about God does not do anything except by His word. And He said, His word, though somebody can hear it 10 years ago, it is still going to show up and bring out results. So I found that truly, you know, God was speaking in a way of saying, we do misunderstand Him. that when he speaks, we think he is just speaking.
Ore ha bolela rena na no re bolela fela.
We have got God who speaks and does what he says.
Rena le nto ya mo ya rena le modimo ya bolelang a dia se se boletse.
His ways are so different.
Tsela tsa gae di fapane.
And then also he have got his own timing.
Ele hape ona le nako ya.
Tsela my friend, God have got his own timing.
Bo cha mtoleng ga o fere modimo na le nako ya gae.
Can I tell you this?
Ere ke le bo tshe.
One of the things that makes God to be different with
us. Ya mo ya re modimo a fapane le rena.
Is when after he spoke a word.
Ka mara wa ra bolele lentse modimo.
He said his own time which is known by him alone.
Ye itse wa nke na le teng.
And this makes God to be more complicated.
Ere ke le modimo ina ka takane dilo tsa gae o la sa kwisha.
He have got his own way. Even today, God wants to use another way to bring solution unto your life. Sometimes we end up deducing, end up thinking, our perspectives takes us somewhere. But you fight at the end, God was saying this. I don't know if you're hearing me. Can you tell anybody, say, my friend, you won't understand God and finish
him.
He have got his way of doing things. That's what I say, my friend. He's putting you in his process. There, are some people who are here today. They are in the process of the living God. And some people, they don't understand what is happening with them. Listen, what he has spoken, it will be like a snow that falls down. But when it reaches down there, it has got something to do on the ground. Our God is not so stupid. There is assignment and time. There is a season to fulfill whatever he says. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I read Mark 8, especially verse 22. I want to read that verse there. I found this God is having his ways. That's why he brought you today here. The way you came, you came by his process. I don't know if you're hearing me. Let's read there. Mark
8.
Let's go to 22.
Verse 22.
Let me read for you. The Bible says, then they came to Bethsaida, and some people brought a blind man to Jesus and begged him to touch him. Taking the blind man by the hand, he led him out of the village. And after spitting on his eyes and laying his hands on him, he asked him, do you see anything? And he looked up and said, I see people, but they look like trees walking around. Then again, Jesus laid his hands on his eyes, and the man stared instantly, and he was restored, and he began to see everything clear. Can you see that?
Amen.
And he sent him to his home, saying, do not even enter the village. Can you see the verse there? When I read this, I found God's way are different with us. Look here, Jesus has never failed to heal anybody who comes to him. But when we read here, when these people brought this man who was blind to Jesus, it was like Jesus has failed. It was like, you know, Jesus is trying to find some means of dealing with the blind man. The Bible says he took the man outside of the village. And when he reached outside of the village, he began to spit down and took the spittle to put it on the eyes. Look how Jesus does things. These people came with expectation, understanding that something would happen there. But Jesus took them outside of the village. He knew what was in the village. He understood that if he can receive healing in the village, he can still lose it in that village. And the Bible says he took him outside of the village. When he reached outside, it was not easy for him to receive also. He put him in a process. I don't know if you are hearing me. Listen to this. They had their own process. Maybe they were coming to test Jesus if he can heal. And Jesus knew that the miracle won't happen same time. He have to move with this man. There are some people who are here that people are looking on you and see the miracle will happen same time. I'm here to tell you, he put you in a process so that when you receive, you won't lose what you have received. Listen to this. Sometimes he qualifies you to be fit for the miracle he's giving you. Because if you just receive it, you can lose it just a minute. And Jesus took him around. He was here with them. They were watching what he will do. But he walked with him. Listen to this. I'm here to tell you that miracle, you will get it. It's that you were in the process of the living God. I'm here to tell you that you are on the way. He wants to walk with you first so that you hear what he says on the road, you and him alone. He wants you to understand that when he takes you on the other side, it's not fit for you to go around and enter the village. There are people who are listening to me today here. They've been delayed and they're worried. I'm here to tell you, you were in God's process. He was processing you. He removed you from his grace and take you where there is nobody. There is nobody in the village who claim that miracle. That's why Jesus took the man outside of the village and said, you are receiving here where there is no any altar of anybody, where there is no ground of anybody. I'm here to tell you that nobody will be able to claim your miracle from now, because God is taking you to a place where nobody will say he's assisted you. Listen, if Jesus might have healed him, these people who brought him, they will praise themselves. But what Jesus did was, hey, you have brought him here, but it's me to take him forward. Let me walk with him until something happened there. Listen, the Bible says when they were outside there, the first miracle happened. When he looked, he was not seeing clear. Because it's happening to us even today. It's like God is not blessing us clearly. And people are looking as if God is failing. Can I tell you here, you are in the process of the living God. There's something is removing from you. You will see clear. You will have a miracle that people will praise the living God about you. And if you believe, shout hallelujah. Shake somebody, say, hey, it's like it's nothing is happening, but my Jesus is taking me there. It's like nothing is happening, but the Lord is in control even right now. There are some people who are here today that they need to hear the sound of my voice. I'm here to tell you, it's like you are not yet there. It's like you are disappointed. It's like things are very hard for you. But can I tell you this? God doesn't want anybody to attest on the miracle you are receiving. He wanted you and he. What was happening? He was walking with you. Walking with you. So that you reach a level where the miracle will be clear. And this is today, you will receive a clear miracle today. Not a fake, a clear. Not a fake car. Not a fake house. house, not just a testimony, people will see it. And from today, when you live here, you will go home rejoicing. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Shake somebody and say, hey, don't laugh at me. I'm in God's process. Don't joke about me. God is working something. Don't worry about me. I'm in the ways of the living God. He's dealing with me. He's removing some things. He's penalizing me. He's establishing me. When I stand my ground, nobody will be able to stop me. If you believe, shout hallelujah. When I read Job 36, 21 to 33, you know, Job was saying, who can say, God, you have done wrong, when I was born in the family of Makananiza? Who can say, God, you have done wrong? Who can say what Job has experienced was wrong? Because he has got his ways. He wants to lift Job to a higher level. Who can say you were wrong when you are born in that family? Somebody did wrong. God was wrong. I was still supposed to be born in Makananisa family. Listen, if not, you were not supposed to be existing. There are ways of the living God. When Job was facing challenges, it was like Job was complaining, but he was not sinning. He understood that he is supposed to face what he is facing, but he knew that his Redeemer lives. Can I tell you this? Sometimes we underline things and we think God is not aware. Whereas is the way, is the way of our God to take us where people will praise his name. I don't know if you are hearing me. Can I tell you this? I was telling people one day here, and some people were really emotional about it. But you know, if this thing didn't happen, I was not supposed to be here. I told people that, you know, something wrong happened in my family. And by then, when I was doing a trick, my father went away, my mom went outside. And all the time, I was asking myself questions and say, what is happening? Why this thing happened? Until I found out, when I found out, I realized that I could not be where I am. I was supposed to be a teacher, teaching or doing something else. I could not be where I am. And you know what happened? When this thing happened, I told people that I stayed in 5 villages with different people. I just stayed there. My mom was there. My father was there. 5 villages. I stayed here. I stayed there. And think about what I was experiencing. I have not told anybody in my life what I've experienced when I was staying in 5 villages. I don't know if you're hearing me. And now when I found, I was excited. I began to understand that the problem of my parents was not a problem, was a God's way. And when God does it, He knew He wants people to forget me. What happened? The people I grew up with, they forgot me. My family forgot me. You know, they began to see me on TV. And I began to understand that what I was supposed to be, it has got no connection with my family. I don't know if you are hearing me. Listen to this. Stop blaming your parents. Stop blaming your family. When they've got problems, take it like it's a lost toy. I don't know if you're hearing me. Well, this thing happened. I stopped complaining. I began to pray. I found that there's nothing I can do except prayer and the word of God. Because God was taking me there. I'm here to tell you that that problem of your family was very good for you. That problem of your enemies was very good for you. I'm here to tell you that the challenge you are facing is very good. There is something that my God wants to do about your life. Listen, you are in God's process. He takes you from here and bring you here, and he takes you from here and take you there. And there are some people who are here who are asking themselves questions. I'm here to answer you today. That problem of divorce, that problem of rejection, that problem you are facing is a God's process. It's a God's process. When you believe God, you will start to have a test. You will live a life that will change everything. You will live a life of your assignment. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Who can say to God, you have done wrong? Who can say that? After that, I began to find that I can cope with anybody. I can live life. You know, my pride was broken. I can access myself. My poverty has helped me. Even when I'm blessed, it can't change my character. Listen to this. If you don't go God's process, you can be changed by money. You can be changed by friends. You can be changed by blessing. If you don't go his process, the process of God hooks you. Establish you. When you come out, you come out in a right time. You'll be blessed in a right time. You'll be used by God in a right time. I don't know if you're hearing me. There's someone who's listening to me. He's been facing a lot. I'm here to tell you that from today, you will come out and people will praise your God if you believe. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know if you are hearing that. I just remember when I'm speaking with you, the story of the man who slept 38 years. Look at God's process. The man who slept very close to the healing place, where people overtake him, and where family reject him, where nobody can remember him, where the Bible can say invalid man. Listen to this. There are some times where your name will be buried and you find no one knows you. No one knows you. No one remember you. You find God has put you in his pot. He's cooking you. He's really cooking you. He poured the salt and he tested it, and he found you are not there. He added the water. There are some people who are here. God was adding the salt. Sometimes when he said that the salt was too much, he put the water and he tried to find if you are delicious. And when you are delicious, he takes you out of the pot. Listen to this. There's no pot that does not face fire. Listen, for you to come out being an example around, you must go through fire. You must be cooked, and you become what God wants you to be. When you come out, when you pass, everybody will talk about you. This is the time when people will talk about you. I don't know if you are hearing me. Check somebody and say, hey, I'm hearing your smell. I'm hearing your good smell. You are in God's process. You are in God's process. I'm hearing your smell. You are about to come out from the pot. You are about to be known. You are about, I'm hearing your smell. You are about to be a manager. about to own a company. You are about to reach a level I'm hearing you smell. Can you stand up and tell three people, I'm hearing you smell. I'm hearing your good smell. I'm hearing your good smell. You are about to come out. If you are watching, you are about. I say you are about to come out. To be known. You are about. You are about to be known. In the name of Jesus. Sit down. Can I tell you this? When you're in God's process, I've done science.
The
processes, they do process. They want to produce sulfuric acid. They're spending, there's some kind of things. There are things that God was doing. When he wants to produce you, when you see some people hating you, hey, you are in God's process. When you see people talking about you, just know that you are in God's process. Whatever you are seeing, just say, oh, I understand. I'm in God's process. Very soon, I'll be celebrated. I see your celebration. I see your celebration. I say it is your season of celebration. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Look at this 2 Kings 4. You must go and read it at home. 2 Kings 4, verse 8 to 16.
Verse 8 to 16.
If you read there, you find a story of a woman who was very rich, but she didn't have a child. She was very rich. I've read so much about this woman. What was important here was she can farm and harvest a lot. But there was no child. She was still a joke. You know, when you have a child, you have a hope. Herself was saying, if she die here, because even her husband, the Bible says, was old. If she die here, she would take what she has worked for and spread it to the world. But you know, it took this woman when God was teaching her. There's a lesson she found when she was in God's process. Can I tell you that lesson? She has gone through false prophets to extend that she end up learning and see who is a prophet or not. And the Bible says when the prophet Elisha was passing, she told her husband, say, yeah, according to the process I went through, this one is a holy man of God. This one is the right one. Can I tell you this? The reason why we fail to dissect is because we are jumping some stages. There are some things we don't know that God can take us to teach us. Some problems we are facing are there to open our eyes to know, so that we must not go and fall on the same traps. Through the process she went through, there were some men who say, your child is coming. Your child is coming. But it's only Elisha. And the Bible says she used a mind. In other words, she used her own ability of experience that she was experiencing when she's living with the servant of God. And when she looked, she said, this one is a holy man of God. Let's do something about it, so that he come to our house. She was no longer expecting anything. In her life, she was doing that to serve God, so that when she died, she will go to heaven. Because already her husband was old. She was serving God, looking where she's going. And the Bible says, the man of God, one day when he was sitting, siku rin'wana loko he told a servant, he say, and this woman has done a lot. It means it's not issue of just putting the man of God there. It means there were things that she was doing, because she understood with her own knowledge that this one is a man of God, I must do something. And the Bible says, you know, that man say, what is it that must be done for her? The problem was clear.
Problem yena ai bonakala kahle ka
gagas. The problem was known to the village.
Problem ai tiviwane hi vanhu.
To extend that this man say yes. Man of God, I've seen everything she has.
Mina ni bona una swilo hinkwaso mani loyi.
But there's this painful thing.
Mara kona swilo swimani
leso. She doesn't have a child.
Anga na nwana.
Man of God say, ah, what I speak, if you have reached the fullness of the process, it will happen. Bring her here. And when the woman came, this man Elisha was supposed to have said, you have gone all the process, and you were tested until now. What you were doing for me, what you have done to other men of God who lied to you. But this time, can I tell you, what you have been crying for, which is a baby, next year this time, you will be holding that baby. And that woman, because she knows the experience, she said, please, man of God, I know you are a man of God. I've gone through problems. I faced a lot. I went on one-on-one in Madombija. I went to Pulukwani one-on-one. I went to Joburg one-on-one. And I went to Pretoria one-on-one. Now you, I'm here in
Tembisa.
Don't lie to me, man of God. I'm here to tell you. I'm not lying to you. I'm here to tell you. From here now, a testimony will follow you. Is that you were in the process? That process is over. I said, that process is over. Shake somebody and say, hey, I know people around me now because I'm suffering. But my suffering is over. I know to live without money, but money is coming to me. I was in the process of the living God. But this time is my time. I need Christians who are saying, hey, there is no more delay in my life. As I'm here, I have finished the process by my God. I'm coming out to be what God wants me to be. I'm coming out to be an example in my family. I'm coming out to be number one in my family. I'm coming out to get a gender. I'm coming out to get my business. I'm coming out to take my higher position. I'm coming out to do things that has not been done in my generation. I'm coming out to be what God wants me to be. It is your time to come out and be what God wants you to be. It is your time. I'm here to tell you, you have been waiting for this time. Hey!
Hey!
You have been waiting for this time. I see my God advertising you. I see those who are against you. They are beginning to surrender today. I say your season has come. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shake somebody and say, hey, my sister has come. My sister has come. Can you tell your neighbor your surname? Say, have you ever heard?
san sifanisi.
Have you ever heard?
Kile watwana.
This same.
Sifanisi.
Tell your neighbor the same.
Kusolen kausulu wena sifanisi.
Say.
Ore wena.
You are about to hear.
Na ke kausulu utwa.
You are about to hear.
Wena kausulu utwa.
I'm out of the process of the living God.
Si la yele ya mutimu.
If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say I'm out.
Ere kusulu.
It is my time.
Ina koya kaya. Kusulu.
I'm out.
Kusulu.
I'm out. I'm free. I'm free.
I'm free.
Can you take your house? I can hear you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
God's process is not easy. You can ask pastors who will tell you. God's process. Some people think by a gift they will come out and make it.
We
want to just get a small gift. They can make us pastor. Ask business people also. Ask workers what they are facing. Ask what is happening in the company.
Which is company.
Waking up in the morning, go there. And when you trust in the Lord, from now on, I see you now. God has opened a door for you. The door is open. I said, the door is open. I said, trusting and holding on is not easy.